Good morning, students. Welcome to our e-learning program. So today, our topic is cubic polynomial. This topic is one of the most important topic for class 10. So before that, you know what is cubic polynomial? A cubic polynomial is a polynomial in which the maximum power of variable is 3. It means the degree of the polynomial is 3. So the general form of the polynomial is px equals to px for the polynomial, and the general form of cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a is not equals to 0. A cannot be equals to 0, because if a is equals to 0, it hampers the existence of cubic polynomial. So a cannot be 0, b, c and d can be 0, and a, b, c, d are the real numbers. And the number of 0 depends on the degree of the polynomial. That's why the number of zeros for this polynomial is 3, named alpha, beta and gamma. So there is relationship between zeros and coefficients. First relationship is alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is minus b by a, where b is the coefficient of x square and a is the coefficient of x cube. Second relationship is the sum of the product of consecutive zeros taken two at a time. Sum of the product of two zeros taken, sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time is c by a, where c is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x cube. And the next relationship is alpha, beta and gamma, product of zeros. Product of zeros minus d by a, where d is constant term and a is the coefficient of x cube. So now we come to the alpha, beta and gamma are the zeros of polynomial. It means x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma are the factors of the polynomial. So when we multiply x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma, we get the polynomial ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So we can write ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d equal to x minus alpha, x minus beta and the x minus gamma, the product of x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma. After the multiplying x minus alpha and x minus beta, we get x square minus x alpha plus beta plus alpha beta, and the remaining term is x minus gamma. After that, x cube multiplying x cube minus x square alpha plus alpha beta x minus gamma x square plus gamma x alpha plus beta minus alpha beta. This is the product of x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma. After solving, we get at last x cube minus x square alpha plus beta plus gamma plus x alpha beta beta gamma alpha minus alpha beta gamma. So to make the equal coefficients, we divide the polynomial by a. So we get ax cube by a, bx square by a, cx by a and d by a. X cube, then right side, x cube minus x square alpha plus beta plus gamma minus x alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha minus alpha beta gamma. For that, x cube minus b by a x square plus cx by a plus d by a equal to x cube minus x square alpha plus beta plus gamma plus x alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha minus alpha beta gamma. By equating the coefficients, we get the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. X square plus c by a x plus d by a equal to x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma x square plus x alpha beta beta gamma plus gamma alpha minus alpha beta gamma. After equating the coefficients, we get equating the coefficients means we equate the coefficient of x cube with x cube, that is 1. Coefficient of x square is b by a, and here the coefficient of x square is minus alpha theta plus gamma. By here only we get alpha plus theta plus gamma, that is sum of the zeros of polynomial is minus b by a. Similarly, c by a is the coefficient of x, and here the coefficient of x is alpha beta beta gamma and gamma alpha. From here only we get alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha equal to c by a, that is sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time. Now last one is d by a and minus alpha beta gamma. So alpha beta gamma, that is product of the zeros, is minus d by a. So students, please remember that the general form of the polynomial is, cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a cannot be equals to 0. Number of zeros is 3, alpha, beta and gamma. Relationship between zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is sum of the zeros minus b by a. Sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time, alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha, c by a. And the product of zero, alpha, beta, gamma equal to minus b by a. And we can generate a polynomial having the zeros alpha, beta and gamma. Bx equal to x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma, sum of the zeros x square plus alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha x minus alpha beta gamma. If you have three zeros alpha beta and gamma, you can generate a cubic polynomial by this only. So not just take an example. Find a cubic polynomial having zeros minus 1, 1 and 2, and also find the relationship between zeros and coefficients. So here zeros are minus 1, 1 and 2, that therefore alpha equals to minus 1, beta equal to 1 and gamma equal to 2. We put in place of alpha minus 1, in place of beta 1 and in place of gamma 2. So required polynomial px equal to, in the format of x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma x square plus alpha beta beta gamma x minus alpha beta gamma. After solving, we get x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. So the relationship between zeros and coefficients are verified here. Alpha plus beta plus gamma, minus 1 plus 1 plus 2, minus 1 alpha, 1 beta, 2 gamma. The result is 2, and minus b by a. Here you see the coefficient of x square is minus 2. Coefficient of x square is minus 2 by 2 is 2. So it is verified. Alpha, beta, beta, gamma and gamma alpha, minus 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2 plus 2 into minus 1 equals to minus 1. After solving we get minus 1, and by the polynomial x cube minus 2x square plus x minus 2, c by a, c is the coefficient of x, and here c, the coefficient of x is minus 1, so minus 1 by 1, minus 1. So it is also verified. And the last one is alpha beta gamma, the product of 0, minus 1, 1 and 2. The product is minus 2 and the coefficient minus b is 2, minus 2 by a coefficient of x cube, 1. So minus 2 by a, 2 or minus 2 by 1, minus 2 is also verified. So this is the example. By the given zeros, we can find the polynomial also.